you to mute yourself unless and until I ask somebody to reply. Okay. If there is any serious problem, then only unmute yourself and then call me. Okay. Refrigeration. Refrigeration is a science or phenomena dealing with temperatures below ambient temperature. Dealing below ambient temperature means what? Suppose my temperature, room temperature or ambient temperature or atmospheric temperature is 30 degrees centigrade. So below that means 28, 29, 26, 27, 0, anything. If you are dealing with those temperatures, it is ambient. It is refrigeration. If I want to cool the water below 30 degrees centigrade, below ambient temperature, it is cooling or refrigeration. And above 123 Kelvin, now from where this temperature has come, 123 Kelvin, 123 Kelvin is a cryogenic temperature. Below this, the gases freezes. It liquefies. It not freezes, it liquefies. Okay. So, therefore, the temperature above 123 degrees centigrade, who is doing this mischievousness? Who is doing this? Erase all. Don't do anything on screen. Okay. So 123 Kelvin means it is a cryogenic temperature. Iske niche agar hum jate hai to gases jaise nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, helium ye liquefy hota hai. Isliye ye jo temperature hai, ye temperature ke below kya hota hai? Cryogenic temperature. To iske abhav hamara kya hai? Yani 123 Kelvin ke abhav refrigeration, but below ambient temperature. For example, if I take Nagpur, room temperature 35 degrees centigrade, and I want to bring the room, yahan se main lecture de raha hu, usko 20 degrees centigrade lana hai, I want to bring that room, then I will have to on the air conditioning. It will be cooling or refrigeration. But for Moscow, ambient temperature is minus 10 degrees centigrade, I am delivering the lecture from Moscow. Temperature is 20 degrees centigrade. You will have to heat it. You cannot. This is not the refrigeration. And if Srinagar temperature is 20 degrees centigrade, room temperature 20 degrees centigrade, so neither heating nor cooling. Okay. Kole or Rao, is the things going fine? Please unmute yourself and tell me, is everything fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now refrigeration. By refrigeration, cooling effect is produced. Ambient temperature 37 degrees centigrade, 310 Kelvin. So now let me take an example of fridge. Fridge ke andar kya hai? Fridge ke andar hai all the things which we want to cool, which we want to preserve. Even the coronavirus can be preserved at low temperature. So here, if I am having a fridge, a student of mine is standing before it. Yes, don't put the dots. Is someone editing? Erase it. So there is an ice box which is at lowest temperature, that is minus 15 degrees centigrade or 258 Kelvin. Now how the cooling will take place? There is below it is cooling space where the temperature is 10 degrees centigrade. Lowest temperature is at the ice box. So ye cooling space ye 10 degrees centigrade hai. jo B that is below ambient temperature, that is 310 Kelvin or 37 degree centigrade. Now I want to cool the water bottle at 30 degree centigrade, 303 Kelvin. I place the bottle in the fridge. The warm air, which is at 10 degree centigrade in the fridge, now I should not call it warm air, it should be cold air. But why warm air? That will come to you now. What will happen? This air at 10 degree centigrade will absorb the heat from the water. So its temperature will become more than 10 degree centigrade. And it will rise up. It will go to ice box. Well, ice box pe temperature uska kya ho jayega? Cold ho jayega. Minus 15 degree centigrade. Because ice box is at minus 15 degree centigrade. Now this cold is heavier, will come down. This is nothing but natural phenomena. Again, it will take the heat from the water, will rise up, and the cooling phenomena will take place. The refrigeration will take place. Right? Unit of refrigeration. Consider a room. In olden days, in America, they used to use ice for cooling. Okay, and what for cooling was done? It was done for preserving food materials. So how they used to cool? They used to ship the ice from Canada. Okay, because Canada was more colder and nearer to America. From there, ice used to come. They used to buy the ice in tons. So they have placed the ice in the room. What happens? Heat from the room, which is greater than the room temperature, is greater than the ice, it will transfer to ice. And the ice will melt. Ice will fuse. Ice ye melt hoga. Ice fuse hoga. Kyun hoga? Kyunki room ka temperature jyada hai, ice ka temperature kam hai. So, refrigeration is rate of heat transfer from a hot body to cold body. Hot body to cool body. So room air was hot, ice was cool, so there was the heat transfer from the room to air, room to ice. So the SI unit is joules per second, rate of heat transfer per unit time. Generally we deal with kilojoules per second because all the properties of refrigerant are given in kilojoule per kg. General unit, ton of refrigeration. Why ton of refrigeration? America used to buy the ice from Canada in tons. Our ton is 1000 kg, American ton is less than 1 ton, less than 1000 kg. So again, I will define 1 ton of refrigeration. Now start noting down this. It is the refrigerating effect produced by melting of 1 US ton of ice. Why ice is melting? Because it is absorbing heat from the room. How much is 1 US ton of ice? It is 907.185 kg. And fusion is taking place. Phase change always takes place at a constant temperature, that is at 0 degrees centigrade at a given pressure. Now it will melt. It will melt to water. So when 1 kg of ice melts, it will absorb 336 kilojoule. Jab 1 kg of ice melt hoga, to kitna heat absorb karega wo? 336 kilojoule. Right? So that, and the temperature remains constant. Temperature kaisa hai iska? That is remaining constant. अब वो हीट तो एब्जॉर्ब कर रहा है, टेम्परेचर चेंज नहीं हो रहा है, इसलिए उसको लैटेंट हीट बोलते, छुपी हुई हीट। इन 24 आवर्स, in how is 1 tons of refrigeration, that agar maine ice liya room mein kal raat ko 10 baje dekha usme place kiya room mein kya kiya usko place kiya I placed ice yesterday at 10 pm now it starts melting it starts absorbing heat at a certain rate it is producing cooling effect and the ice is melting to water now if the whole melting process last drop last particle of ice melts after 24 hours just at the stroke of 24 hours yani aaj 10 baje wo pura melt ho gaya to isko bolte hum 1 ton of refrigeration so 1 ton of refrigeration kya hai 1 us ton of ice kaun se solid ice 0 degree वो क्या हो रहा है मेल्ट हो रहा है टू वाटर एट 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड कैसा मेल्ट होता है कंप्लीटली और वो मेल्टिंग को टाइम कितना लग रहा है 24 घंटे 24 आवर्स देन दैट कूलिंग रेट इज कॉल्ड एज 1 टन ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन सो इफ यू कैलकुलेट फॉर 1 टन ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन रेफ्रिजरेटिंग इफेक्ट क्यू Q will be equal to M into latent heat. That is the total amount of heat absorbed in how much time? 24 hours. It comes out to be 3.528 by above values. Standard value is 3.52 kilojoules per second. So 1 ton of refrigeration is 3.52 kilojoules per second. So note down this definition. This definition is very, very important. For sharing PPT to you, I will think of later. You should now study. Don't observe this PPT presentation as a film. Okay, that's why I have said that. With copy, pencil, pen, your tables, calculator, you should be present. Next. Don't draw anything on the screen. So let us start vapor compression refrigeration system. Before starting that, I want some of your responses. Somebody is doing some mischievousness on the screen. And I can know that person. Okay, please stop doing that, because who is editing all is visible to the Khedkar sir or somebody else who is handling all this. So better way, don't do anything. Yes, Darsh, Darsh Kole, are you hearing me? Is everything going fine? Please tell me.
Yes, sir. All
right. Okay. Now, vapor compression refrigeration system. Let us start with ice box. Ice box is nothing but evaporator. And why it is called evaporator? Because here the liquid refrigerant enters the evaporator and gets converted to vapor. So liquid refrigerant will be converted to vapor in the evaporator, liquid to vapor. That's why liquid evaporates to vapor. इसलिए इसको क्या बोलते हैं evaporator. Now how is this evaporator? Now जो picture दिख रहा है आपको ये air conditioner का evaporator. It is the air conditioner evaporator. Ice box भी evaporator. ये जो अंदर tubes दिख रही है from here the refrigerant is entering the tubes and it will flow through this, absorb the heat and go out. Right? So the refrigerant enters here, moves through the tubes of the temperature evaporator. Temperature is at 10 degrees centigrade and my room temperature is say 20 degrees centigrade. So hot air, that is air at 20 degrees centigrade, will flow through this flow across the evaporator and I will get the cold air. Now this cold air will be nearly about at say 0 degree centigrade and so on. This air will go inside the room, absorb the heat from the room, again will come to the temperature 20 degrees centigrade and in this the evaporator of air conditioner works. Now it is absorbing the heat from the hot air. It is the, say the heat absorbed is 100 kilojoules per second. Who is absorbing it? Refrigerant. How is that refrigerant? Mostly liquid. But there is some vapor, so it is called as wet refrigerant. Its state will be always denoted by 4. So refrigerant entering evaporator, uski condition hum log 4 se define karenge. State number 4, it is mostly wet. It absorbs heat from evaporator, say 100 kilojoules per second, aur wo kya banegi? Dry or superheated refrigerant. Kya banega wo? Dry or superheated refrigerant. Now if it is dry, its temperature will be minus 10 degree centigrade. Superheated raha to uska minus 10 se jyada rahega. It may be 5, 10, anything else. Now this 100 kilojoules per second jo heat absorb ki hai, ye heat ko mujhe kya karna padega? Mujhe karna padega this 100 kilojoules per second. Ye jo heat hai, इसको मुझे रिजेक्ट करना पड़ेगा कहीं पे. तो क्यों रिजेक्ट करना पड़ेगा? बिकॉज दिस रेफ्रिजरेंट शुड अगेन कम बैक एट दिस कंडीशन 4. सो लेट्स सी दिस रेफ्रिजरेंट का जो टेम्परेचर कितना है एट कंडीशन 1, से इट इज -5 और 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. अब ये 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड पे जो रेफ्रिजरेंट है एट कंडीशन 1, दिस विल आई विल हैव टू टेक टू कॉम्प्रेसर. Is anybody locking my screen? Wait for 5 minutes. Let me talk to Kirkar sir. If anybody is doing mischievous, please stop it. Okay, somebody was drawing earlier. Sarvesh, am I audible?
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay. So again, I will start. Wet refrigerant enters the evaporator, absorbs the heat from the surrounding air or from the surrounding air of ice box. Agar ice box evaporator hai to, then this wet refrigerant will be converted to superheated refrigerant or dry refrigerant. ये dry wet नहीं रह सकता है क्या? Yes, it can be wet, but generally it is dry or superheated. Dry evaporator temperature minus 10, then the temperature of refrigerant, dry refrigerant will be minus 10. If it is superheated, it will be greater than minus 10. And if it is wet, again it will be minus 10. Suppose the refrigerant at one is superheated. Now this refrigerant, we will send it to compressor because I have to reject this heat absorbed by the refrigerant to somewhere. So where I am going to reject it? I am going to reject it to surrounding. जैसे हरदम ऐसा ही रहता है कि हमारे घर में कचरा जमा हो गया तो हम उसको क्या करते हैं? बाहर फेंकते. तो वैसे इसको बाहर फेंकना है, एटमोसफियर में फेंकना है. तो ये रेफ्रिजरेंट को हम कहाँ भेजते? कॉम्प्रेसर. कहाँ से आ रहा है? इवेपोरेटर पे. प्लीज म्यूट करो, जो भी बात कर रहा है म्यूट करो. म्यूट इट. हाँ, रेफ्रिजरेंट कॉम्प्रेसर में एंटर करेगा, उसको हम कॉम्प्रेस करेंगे. क्यों करना है कॉम्प्रेस? देयर इज द रीजन दैट नाउ द रेफ्रिजरेंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर शुड बी ग्रेटर देन एटमोस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर. तो ही हमारा हीट जो है इवेपोरेटर से एब्जॉर्ब हुई है वो कहाँ रिजेक्ट होगी? एटमोस्फियर. It will be transferred from any body whose temperature is greater than atmospheric. temperature to atmosphere. Now this compressor will receive work. Compressor के लिए हमको prime mover लगाना पड़ता है, maybe electric motor or diesel motor. और वो क्या करता है, वर्क करता है वो रेफ्रिजरेंट जो -10 या -5 या 0 पे आया, इट विल कॉम्प्रेस इट और उसका टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा. कितना बढ़ेगा? इट विल इंक्रीज ग्रेटर देन एटमॉस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर. सो इट विल बी सेंट टू कंडेंसर. कंडेंसर इज वाटर कूल कंडेंसर. एटमॉस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, इट इज 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. सो वॉट दिस कॉम्प्रेसर इज डूइंग, it is compressing the refrigerant, right? And due to compression, volume kam karne ke karan uska pressure badhta hai aur temperature bhi badhta hai. Temperature will increase to more than 40 degree centigrade, say 50 degree centigrade, 60 degree centigrade, anything. Now ye jo hai superheated refrigerant, when it is sent to condenser, what will happen? It will reject heat. जिसका टेम्परेचर 60 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड था, एटमॉस्फेयर से ज्यादा था, सो इट विल रिजेक्ट हीट एंड विल कंडेंस टू एटमॉस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर आइडियली एट 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. नाउ हाउ दिस इक्वेशन, QC इज इक्वल टू QE प्लस WC. द इक्वेशन इज, हमने हीट कितने अब्सॉर्ब किया एट इवेपोरेटर, 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. ओके, कितनी हीट एब्जॉर्ब की है, 100 किलो जूल्स पर सेकेंड. दिस एनर्जी इज कमिंग टू रेफ्रिजरेंट फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग जो कूल कर रहे हैं. हियर वी आर सप्लाइंग फॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग दिस कॉम्प्रेशन, फॉर डूइंग द कॉम्प्रेशन वी आर सप्लाइंग 20 किलो जूल्स पर सेकेंड. सो एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉट बी डिस्ट्रॉयड. जितनी एनर्जी आई उतनी मुझे बाहर फेंकनी पड़ेगी, 120 किलो जूल्स पर सेकेंड. ओके, नाउ दिस हीट इज रिजेक्टेड टू एटमॉस्फेयर. आफ्टर दिस फेज चेंज होगा रेफ्रिजरेंट का, क्या होगा, सुपर हीटेड टू, पहले डिग्री ऑफ सुपर हीट निकालेंगे, फिर उसका फेज चेंज शुरू होगा एंड इट विल देन कंडेंस टू -40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. इफ कूलिंग वाटर इज सप्लाइड इट मे रीच बिलो 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं सब कुल लिक्विड. सो अगेन, दोज हु इज डूइंग द मिस्चीवियसनेस, प्लीज स्टॉप इट. खेड़कर सर आपको ये कर रहे हैं, डोंट लॉक माय स्क्रीन. प्लीज स्टॉप दिस. हु हैज लॉक्ड द स्क्रीन? So condenser. Here the superheated refrigerant will enter the condenser, leave the condenser in which form, either liquid or subcooled liquid. This such liquid or saturated liquid, the temperature will be 40 degree centigrade, subcooled or to below 40, say 30. Then it is expanded in expansion wall. Expansion wall kya rehta hai? A capillary tube. Refrigerator jinhone theek tarah dekha hoga, they will see the capillary tube outside the body of refrigerator and isenthalpic expansion will take place. Okay, please give me feedback that everybody is getting this, or yes, give me the feedback. Pranav Vasnik.
Yes sir,
everything is clear?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Okay. Shall I move forward? Don't draw this. Don't do anything. Everything is clear. So we will move forward.
Yes.
Okay. So now again I will tell the whole process. This is very important. Now you can draw it. A evaporator which is at -10 degree centigrade, it receives the heat 100 kilojoules. Who takes the heat? Refrigerant. How it is? Wet refrigerant. What will be its temperature? Evaporator temperature -10 degree centigrade. If a liquid, liquid will vaporize, phase changes. What happens? Dry or superheated refrigerant will be formed, which superheated at a temperature will be greater than evaporated. It is sent to compressor where it will receive the work. The refrigerant will get superheated. This superheated refrigerant will be sent to condenser. It will reject heat at 120 kilojoules. I have changed the condenser temperature to 30 degrees centigrade. Earlier, I have taken the example of 40 degrees centigrade. Condenser temperature depends upon ambient temperature. Important, very, very important. Condenser temperature is depend karta hai ambient temperature. Ambient temperature kis depend karta hai location hai. So again, this superheated refrigerant will condense to subcooled liquid or saturated liquid refrigerant, and its temperature will be either less than 30 or equal to 30. Less than equal to 30, it is saturated liquid. Then it is sent to expansion wall and back. So this sketch I have given to you, and many of you would have drawn this. Those who have not drawn this will. I have this uploaded in the. Now, water boils at 100 degrees centigrade if the pressure is 1 bar. If boiling temperature, if I decrease the boiling pressure, what will happen? Boiling temperature will decrease. So, ये boiling pressure और boiling temperature की जोड़ी रहती है. जहाँ पे liquid vapor नहीं रहना चाहता या vapor liquid बनना चाहता है, वो जो phase change का moment है, उस pressure और temperature को हम क्या बोलते हैं? We call it as saturated pressure. और ये saturated pressure कैसे निकालना? Evaporator के लिए evaporator temperature will decide minus 10 degree centigrade. Now mind well, ये जो boiling pressure अगर मैंने कम किया, जैसे मैंने बोला 1 bar पे water boils at 100 degree centigrade. If I decrease the pressure, the boil water will boil below 100 degree centigrade. Means what? Lower the temperature, lower is the pressure. Same is case with refrigerant. रेफ्रिजरेंट का प्रेशर अगर इवेपोरेटर टेम्परेचर कम करना है माइनस 10, तो प्रेशर विल डिक्रीज. अगर माइनस 20 किया और कम होगा, माइनस 30 किया और कम होगा. इफ द फेज चेंज एट 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड द प्रेशर विल बी मोर. सो फेज चेंज मीन्स लिक्विड टू वेपर या वेपर टू लिक्विड. इवेपोरेटर में क्या हो रहा है? लिक्विड टू वेपर. यहां पे liquid आ रहा है, liquid will be converted to vapor and it will take place at minus 10 degree centigrade and pressure will correspond to, what? It will correspond to, minus 10 degree centigrade. That's why the equation P is equal to P sat at T sat is equal to T. यानी अगर हम refrigerant table देखा, तो जो saturated temperature पे हमको वो देखना पड़ेगा. Now similarly condenser pressure, यहाँ पे भी phase change हो रहा है. What is the phase change? From superheated refrigerant to subcooled liquid. यानी vapor superheated से पहले saturated vapor होगा, उसके बाद superheated vapor से saturated vapor होगा, and after saturated vapor the condensation will take place. And when it becomes saturated vapor, its temperature becomes 30 degrees centigrade. Ab yahan se the correct pressure of the condenser will be decided by the TC. And condenser temperature is decided by the ambient temperature. Jaise abhi bataya ki hamara agar Nagpur hai, to condenser temperature will be more than Srinagar, kyunki Srinagar ka ambient temperature kam hai. और ये जो इवेपोरेटर टेम्परेचर, इट इज एज पर आवर रिक्वायरमेंट. मुझे अगर 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड चाहिए फ्रिज के अंदर, तो मेरा टेम्परेचर आएगा माइनस 10. अगर मुझे जो कूलिंग स्पेस है उसका टेम्परेचर -10 चाहिए, तो ये -20 कम करना पड़ेगा। सो यहाँ का प्रेशर कौन डिसाइड करेगा? कंडेंसिंग टेम्परेचर 30°C। So condenser temperature will be decided by PC is equal to Psat at Tsat is equal to Tc. Up the pressure, we will assume there is no losses in the pipeline. So here pressure at 4, evaporator pressure and P1 will remain same. P1, P4 or P1, कौन decide करेगा? Evaporator pressure. Evaporator का pressure कौन decide करेगा? Evaporator temperature. Will decide evaporator pressure, evaporator temperature. Or evaporator temperature, it will be decided by our requirement. Similarly, P2 will be equal to P3 if there is no losses in the system. Or who can decide karega? P2, P3, it will be decided by PC. PC ko can decide karega? Condenser temperature. And condenser temperature can decide karega? It will be decided by the ambient temperature. Okay. ओके केदार गोड़े, यस केदार गोड़े प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ। इज एवरीथिंग क्लियर?
यस सर।
ओके एनी डिफिकल्टी फॉर एनीबडी दे कैन आस्क बट वन बाय वन फॉर 2 मिनट्स व्हेन आई सेड म्यूट इट एनी डिफिकल्टी। Okay, I will move forward. Mute yourself if anybody has unmuted. Now there will be 2 pressures. One is condenser pressure and another is evaporator pressure. So inlet to compressor will be evaporator pressure. Inlet to compressor will be evaporator pressure. So this inlet pressure here at compressor will be decided by the evaporator pressure. And the exit of compressor will be decided by the condenser pressure. For example, at this P is 1 bar and P2 is 12 bar. So compressor will raise the pressure from 1 bar to 12 bar. Then only our system will work. So above this zone, whole above this zone will be at higher pressure. Below this will be at lower. Somebody's mic is on, please mute it. Now let us take the theoretical cycle. There are actually 3 cycles, Carnot cycle, theoretical cycle and actual cycle. Carnot cycle you have studied in the second year thermodynamics. So lower temperature is evaporator temperature, higher temperature is the condenser temperature, and COP of Carnot VCR cycle will be what? It will be T upon TC minus T, all temperatures in Kelvin. Write down. COP of Carnot cycle is, TE, evaporator temperature, whole divided by TC, condenser temperature minus evaporator temperature. All the temperatures in Kelvin. Now for theoretical cycle, we will take some assumptions. The first assumption is that the refrigerant is dry. It is dry at the inlet of compressor or at the exit of evaporator. Means what? T1 will be equal to T. There will be no superheat. Somebody's mic is on. Please close it. Please mute it. Now this refrigerant will send to compressor. So the first assumption, what is the first assumption? That the temperature after evaporator at the entry of compressor, mark, see my marker, it will be dry saturated. So T1 will be equal to T. Now it will be sent to compressor where the work will be supplied to it. And the pressure will rise to PC. Say agar P 1 bar hai, PC 12 bar hai. So from 1 to 12, the compressor will raise the pressure of refrigerant. How is the compression? Next assumption is that the compression is isentropic. For what cycle? Theoretical cycle. S1 is equal to S2. In gas turbines, jet propulsion, we have taken the compression process to be isentropic. Process ideal. Next, then the vapor will become superheated, will be sent to condenser. At condenser, what will happen? At condenser, that liquid will cool, refrigerant will cool down, superheated refrigerant will cool down to 3, where third assumption will come into picture. It is saturated liquid, not the subcooled liquid. So how many assumptions? First assumption, at inlet, it is dry refrigerant at the inlet of compressor. Second assumption is the compression is isentropic. S1 is equal to S2. S1 before entropy of refrigerant before compressor compression and after compression will be C. And the third assumption is that this refrigerant will cool. How it will be cooled? Such that it is saturated liquid. Then this saturated liquid will be sent to expansion valve where the process is isenthalpic. Means enthalpy is H3 is equal to H4. If we see the capillary tube, kya tha expansion valve? Capillary tube. Neither we supply the heat, nor we extract the work, nor we neglect the energy change, apply the steady state flow energy equation, you will get that the enthalpy before and after capillary tube will be same. Okay. Now, why we are using capillary tube? Why not the turbine to decrease the pressure? Why dry refrigerant at the exit of evaporator? This we will discuss later on, maybe tomorrow. Okay. Next. Now, let us take the theoretical cycle. Everybody will now take the sheet of pH chart before him. pH chart ki sheet loge aap aapke samne. Everybody. Most important portion of this theoretical cycle. So let me discuss the theoretical cycle. What are the assumptions? Assumptions are one, dry refrigerant here, then compression is isentropic this, then saturated liquid here, at the exit of condenser and isenthalpic expansion in expansion wall. So these are the assumptions. Okay. Now this is PA chart जो मैंने बोला है आप निकाल के रखो. This y axis is pressure axis and the x is enthalpy axis. Now this this line, pressure line PE, if constant pressure line, evaporator pressure, say it is 1 bar. This is the line. Everybody has got it? Do draw it in your sheet, evaporator line. Now draw pressure line. वो कैसे रहेगी? Evaporator से ऊपर या नीचे? It will be at the above evaporator, condenser. Be greater than evaporator pressure. So is it visible? Condenser line, evaporator pressure. Evaporator pressure line, niche rahegi. You do the problem by chart. Evaporator pressure, condenser pressure line. Okay. This portion of the curve, the आपको saturated liquid curve. This portion, ये यहाँ से ये यहाँ तक. This is saturated liquid curve. Is it visible? Okay. And this curve, यहाँ से critical point से critical point है यहाँ saturated vapor curve. Saturated liquid curve as saturated vapor. The point where it meets, it is called as critical. So, low pressure lines, PE, lower pressure line, PC, or saturated liquid curve or saturated vapor curve. Come here in after condenser. Condenser ke baad mein everybody. Condenser ke baad mein. So this point, saturated liquid, this point, this is saturated liquid, wo point pe aa jao. Now this point 3, ye kaun se pressure pe? Condenser pressure pe. Aur liquid kaisa hai? Saturated liquid. So एनोड एरो नीचे है मुझे. वेयर इज एनोड? सो ये पीसी लाइन, दिस लाइन जो आप मीट हो रही है, किसको मीट हो रही है? सैचुरेशन कर्व. दिस पॉइंट विल बी अवर पॉइंट नंबर 3. दिस पॉइंट विल बी अवर पॉइंट नंबर 3. This point number will be, this point will be point number 3. So here this is point number 3. Somebody says so point number 3 line where PC and saturated liquid curve intersects. Okay. सो दिस इज पॉइंट नंबर थ्री, यहाँ पे दिख रहा होगा पॉइंट नंबर थ्री प्रिंट हुआ है. पॉइंट नंबर थ्री इज स्टेट कंडीशन थ्री इज या पीसी लाइन एंड सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड कर्व इज. सो थ्री फोर इज आइसेंथैल्पिक. आइसेंथैल्पिक लाइंस विल बी वर्टिकल लाइंस. यस, हु इज हु हैज डन दिस. Isenthalpic line is what? It is a vertical line, right? Now H3 will be equal to H4. So on this green arrow, on this green arrow, the fourth point will lie. Now this fourth line, wet refrigerant, this fourth point is will be on the evaporator pressure, and that's why I have said that the refrigerant is wet, right? यहाँ पे कैसे? This is saturated liquid curve, saturated vapor curve, जो zone बीच का है, this is wet vapor. ये जो zone है, मेरा cursor जहाँ दिख रहा है, वहाँ पे कौन सा zone है? वहाँ पे zone है तुम्हारा subcooled. और इधर saturated vapor के right side में superheated vapor, left side में saturated liquid के subcooled. And in between the curve, saturated liquid or saturated vapor is a wet refrigerant. Wet refrigerant का मतलब होता है उसमें vapor भी है और liquid droplets. So the this is isenthalpic process and this is point number four. Okay, from here, what will happen? This refrigerant will go to evaporator. Evaporator में गया तो क्या होगा? It will absorb heat. Well, this line gives me HC is equal to H4. Enthalpy की अगर निकालना है तो यहाँ पे H axis पे मुझे HC is equal to H4. Now from 4, the refrigerant will go from 4 to 1. और ये theoretical है. 1 पे क्या है? Saturated vapor. अगर 1 point मुझे mark करना है तो कैसे mark करूंगा? 1 is at evaporator pressure and 1 is dry refrigerant, saturated vapor. So that will be marked one. उस तरह हम उसको क्या करेंगे? Mark करेंगे. And this one will be our dry saturated vapor of refrigerant from evaporator. बहुत बार जवाब लिखते समय vapor बोला तो आपको एक ही vapor आता है, water vapor. नहीं, vapor हर liquid का vapor होता है. तो यहाँ पे क्या है? Refrigerant का vapor. Question में answer लिखते हुए water vapor लिखते हैं. Water refrigerant used. Water as a refrigerant is never used in VCRF system. So now 1 to 4, क्या होते जा रहा है? From 4, liquid droplets were more, vapor was less. जैसे 4 to 1 जा रहा है, so what is happening in this process? The liquid is decreasing and the vapor is increasing. At 1, liquid quantity is 0 and totally dry superheated vapor. Next, from 1, what will happen? We will get the H1 enthalpy 1. This we are going to use. कहाँ use करेंगे? pH chart से. pH chart से हम लोग H1 निकालें. ठीक है? Next process is isentropic process. This is the isentropic process. हर pH chart में isentropic की curve ऐसा रहेगा. Red line से जैसा रहता है, वैसा isentropic रहता है. Isentropic lines, हर chart, कोई भी refrigerant का chart देखा तो it will be like this, right? Inclined lines or inclined curves. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression, theoretical cycle में compression कैसा है? Isentropic. And then 2 से मुझे क्या मिलेगा? H2 मिलेगा. 2 से क्या मिलेगा? H2 मिलेगा. So from 2 I will get the H2. कहाँ देखो? नीचे देखो, enthalpy के समय. As soon as I use the anode, what happens? It is getting locked. So I am not going to use it. Again, it is locked. From 2, now there will be condensation. पहले तो 2 से ये point तक. कौन से point तक? ये point तक, vapor तक. यहाँ पे degree of superheat निकलेगा. यहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा? Vapor का temperature कम होते जाएगा. कहाँ तक कम होगा? Saturated vapor का. उसके बाद सो अप टू सैचुरेटेड का क्या होगा? यहाँ पे यहां तक हमारा डिग्री ऑफ सुपरहीट कम होगा, टेम्परेचर कम होगा. फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट 2 to 3 चेंज ऑफ फेज विल टेक प्लेस एंड अगेन एट 3 आई विल गेट द सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड. हाँ, एनी बडी इज हैविंग एनी डिफिकल्टी? please ask me right now. Unmute okay. Anay Mukte.
Yes, sir.
Is the things clear to everything? Is everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any difficulty?
Sir, can you please explain the whole cycle on the pH graph once again in short?
Yes. Okay. Mute everybody. Mute it. See, I will start. Always first, I will draw the P and PC line. On the pH curve, all constant pressure lines will be horizontal lines. So first P line, low pressure, PC line, high pressure. Next. The left hand side of the curve is saturated liquid curve. Okay. And the right hand side is saturated vapor curve. This is saturated liquid curve. Okay. And here this is saturated vapor curve. At the top, it is critical point where these two curves meet, critical point. What is the critical point here? Latent heat of vaporization, HFG, is zero. What it is, that we will see it afterwards. Now, why I start with point three? Point three is very easy to mark. And the point three, four is also very, very easy to plot. Okay. So that's why I start. Everybody, I will request you to start from point three. Point three is saturated liquid at condenser pressure. So your saturated liquid curve or condenser pressure, jaha intersect hoga, jaha pe ye intersect ho raha yahan pe. So this is point number three. How is H 3 and 4? 3 and 4 is isenthalpic. 3 and 4 is isenthalpy. Isliye vertical line downward. And this is isenthalpic process. H3 is equal to H4. Ab ye jo refrigerant jaha enter kiya hai pump evaporator, ye dekho, theoretical diagram dekho. Wet refrigerant jaha likha hua hai. Wo evaporator mein jab jata hai, to it will absorb heat. Kaun si heat absorb kar raha hai? Cooling effect wali, refrigerating effect wali. और जो भी लिक्विड है फोर में वो वेपराइज होना शुरू हो जाएगा. कब तक वेपराइज होगा? अनलेट इट बिकम सैचुरेटेड वेपर. सो ये सैचुरेटेड वेपर तक वो क्या हो रहा है हमारा ये जो प्रोसेस है सैचुरेटेड वेपर बिकॉज इट इज थियोरेटिकल साइड राइट इट इज नॉट द एक्चुअल. सो स्टार्टेड विथ थ्री सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड ऑन प्रेशर. We drop the vertical line 3, 4 isenthalpic process. Four lies on P. So we got point four. Four say fill horizontal move away to get the one. Okay. Now after this, I will get 1, 2 is isentropic process. Red line. 1, 2 is isentropic process. Every isentropic line. जो रहेगी पीएच पे वो ऐसे ही रहेगी 1, 2 और फिर यहां पे मुझे 2 पॉइंट मिला 2 से मुझे एंथाल्पी H2 मिलेगी. सो आई हैव गॉट ऑल द एंथाल्पी H2 H3 H4. ये हो गया कि हमारे 6-7 मार्क पक्के हो गए. फिर यहाँ पे इफ आई पॉइंट फाइंड इट करेक्टली आई विल गेट ऑल द मोस्टली प्रॉब्लम इफ इट. And then 2 to 3 is condensation. Condensation से फिर से ही हमारी साइकिल क्या हो गई कंप्लीट. ओके. जिसने मुझे अभी पूछा था रिपीट करने हैज ही गॉट इट.
यस सर गॉट इट.
यस सर यस सर.
एनीबॉडी अनम्यूट होके पूछो कोई डिफिकल्टी हो तो. ओके लेट्स मूव. Let us take the problem and sab jan ammonia chart refrigerant ka kholo uska ammonia chart. I am taking the प्रॉब्लम इज कि 1 टन रेफ्रिजरेशन कूलिंग इफेक्ट चाहिए, मेरे घर में 1 टन का एयर कंडीशनर लगा है, इट ऑपरेट्स बिटवीन टेम्परेचर -10 and 30 degrees centigrade, ऐसा प्रॉब्लम में लिखा रहता है. कैसा लिखा रहता है? इट ऑपरेट्स बिटवीन -10 and 30 degrees centigrade. सो -10 बोला तो वो क्या आएगा? इट विल बी इवेपोरेटर टेम्परेचर. -10 विल बी इवेपोरेटर टेम्परेचर एंड द लार्जर टेम्परेचर विल बी कंडेंसर टेम्परेचर. जो मैंने यहाँ पे गलती की है मैं यहाँ विल रेक्टिफाई. Here it should be TC. Okay. So I will save it. So ammonia charge subject nikal denge. So what is the problem statement? I have an air conditioner or maybe a refrigerator or a water cooler, anything. Ice cream cooler, 1 ton refrigeration, -10 degrees centigrade is evaporator temperature. And the condenser temperature 30 degrees centigrade. I hope so. सबने अमोनिया का चार्ट खोला होगा, साथ में वो पीएच चार्ट भी खोलो, दूसरा वाला पीएच चार्ट लो जो मैंने बोला है, ब्लैंक निकाल के रखो, 2-3 copies वो उसमें से एक पीएच चार्ट लो. अमोनिया चार्ट पे होने तक कुछ मत करो. So this is ammonia chart. Okay. Now see. -20 degrees centigrade देखो यहां से. I will start the anode. Maybe I will have to restart it. I will do it. So this is -20 degrees centigrade. दूसरा -20 degrees centigrade कोई माफ करो, यहां पे दिख रहा है क्या -20 degrees centigrade ऑन सैचुरेशन वेपर का? This is saturated liquid curve. ये जो curve है मेरा, ये कौन सा है? Saturated liquid है. और ये कौन सा है? Saturated vapor curve. दोनों के बीच में क्या है? Wet vapor. ये बीच का portion इन्होंने blank रखा है, इसलिए रखा है कि यहाँ की properties का जल्दी काम नहीं पड़ता. Okay. I think everybody don't use anode. Let me use it. उसके कारण वो lock हो रहा है, if I am not wrong. You have got the permission to use the anode. Please stop it. Maybe that then my system will work smoothly. Okay, it has been locked. I will start again. So stop share. Share screen. Share screen, PowerPoint presentation, share, right, and again I will start. So this line, blue line which you are seeing, it is for -20 degrees centigrade. Now I will request you to draw the line for 30 degrees centigrade and -10 degrees centigrade. Draw it. 30 degree centigrade and -10 degree centigrade. कोई अनम्यूट होके बताओ, ये समझाए क्या -20 का बराबर? यस, -20 की लाइन कैसे निकालिए ये समझाए क्या? सी वेयर देर इज अ फेज चेंज द टेम्परेचर विल रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट. सो ये सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड से यहां से सैचुरेटेड वेपर तक टेम्परेचर क्या रहने वाला? कॉन्स्टेंट. Yes. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Okay. Okay. चलो mute हो जाओ सब. So ये जो है -20 के लिए line हो गई, ये जो दिख रही है blue line. और यहाँ पे हर जगह temperature क्या रहेगा? Minus. वैसे ही -10 के लिए निकालो, 30 के लिए निकालो. Now everybody pay attention. Pay attention. If I draw, go to pressure axis. Yes, -10, correct. If I go to pressure axis, ये माइनस 20 की अगर एक्सटेंड किया तो दिस रेफ्रिजरेंट इज गोइंग टू बॉइल और इवेपोरेट एट 1.8 बार. समझ में आया क्या? यस, अनम्यूट होके बताओ, समझ में आया क्या? रेफ्रिजरेंट विल बॉइल एट 1.8 बार एट माइनस 20 डिग्री
सेंटीग्रेड.
एवरीबॉडी हैज गॉट इट?
यस सर.
यस सर.
ओके ओके ओके. कम ऑन. सो फॉर माइनस 10 टेल मी द प्रेशर. अनम्यूट होके. I should also have the feel of teaching in the classroom, that which I am missing a lot.
2.8 bars.
Yes, yes. Okay. Unmute. Similarly, 30, it will be something about 10.18 bars and something like that. Okay. So if I want, say, my refrigerant boils at minus 10 degrees, if I want to draw the pressure line, so the pressure line dotted dikh rahi hai, everybody should see it. The pressure line for minus 20 degree centigrade corresponding to minus 20 degree centigrade phase change is 1.8 bar. Dotted line may be visible to everybody. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So this pressure P will be equal to Psat at Tsat is equal to minus 20 degree centigrade and its pressure is 1.8 bars. Okay, next. Now another dotted line. Anybody tell me which it will correspond to which temperature? Pressure corresponding to which temperature? Another dotted line. Yes, unmute and tell me.
Condenser.
30 degrees centigrade.
30 degrees centigrade.
Yes. So PC is equal to Psat at Tsat is equal to 30 degrees centigrade. So is equal to sine minus correct it up. Why 30 centigrade? Is equal to Psat at that is equal to 30 degrees centigrade.